Welcome back to Fallout 4. I've done quite a few things off-screen before starting the recording, so let me just catch you up on what I've done. I've gone from settlement to settlement. Each one of these, just making sure everybody's happy. And definitely everybody was not happy, because one of the last things I did last time I went around to all my settlements was build recruitment beacons. And I haven't really been back that much since, which means a lot of people, a lot of new people arrived at these places. Places that before only maybe had 2 or 3 people, now have like 9 or 12 or 11 or 7. So there are a lot of people angry because there wasn't enough water, and in almost every case there wasn't enough beds. So I just built beds, built water, built some food, assigned some people to some things, built more defenses, and I also plopped down the artillery thing at I think every location. So my artillery coverage should be a lot bigger than it was before. I've got to remember that the artillery thing even exists, because to be honest, I totally forgot. So that's done, and I also made a couple weapon modifications. The first thing I did is I actually switched out my shotgun. Where are you? There you are. So I switched out my shotgun, which, or the original one was basically a standard combat shotgun, or whatever it's called.
This place isn't awful.
Yes, thank you.
It's still a hole.
But I switched it out with a special shotgun that I'd found a while ago. Well, let's just look at it. The never-ending combat shotgun. Yeah, so my shotgun before was a combat shotgun, but it wasn't a special one. So this one is essentially the same thing. It's got pretty much the same stats, the only difference being it never runs out of... Well, it never runs out of ammo capacity. Of course, it runs out of ammo if you don't have any shells left, but you'll never need to reload it. So that's nice. The other thing I did is I took my pipe bolt-action rifle, the one that's basically getting used for close-range stuff. I took that one and I changed out the receiver. Before, I had the 45 caliber receiver on it, which has really good damage, and I was using the 45 rounds because I had never really used them before, so I had plenty of ammunition. But as you've been seeing recently, I've been running out of ammo, so I decided to basically just switch it back to the powerful receiver, which once again has me
Nothing
using...
Nothing I hate more than raider scumbags. If you run into
Nothing
any,
I hate more than you! I hate you! I really, really hate you! Please! Please, go join the raiders or something. I don't know. Go live in a cave. Just go away. Okay? Alright. God. Jesus. Ruined my train of thought. So yes, before I had the 45 receiver on, because I didn't use the type of ammo, so there was plenty of it, but I've started to run out recently, so I switched it back to the powerful receiver, which uses 38 rounds, which I think is what it used originally. And as you can see, I have 1,000 shots of that, so I'm not gonna have to worry about ammo for a long time. The only bad thing about it is it doesn't do quite as much damage. It does 30 per shot instead of 35. And also the fire rate is only 55 instead of 83. Which is a big reduction in fire rate, but it's still pretty fast. And since my rifles will cause people to trip when you're scoped in using them, you know, the fire rate really isn't that big of a deal because they're probably going to be stun-locked anyway, falling on the ground, just perpetually tripping on their shoelaces. So, not too big of a deal, as long as it's reasonably fast, which it is. The other thing I did is I replaced the barrel. Before it was a long ported barrel, now it is a long finned barrel. Which doesn't actually affect the stats really at all, but it says it has no accuracy penalty while firing. So I guess it just improves your accuracy, sorta, kinda. It didn't hurt. It's supposed to be better. Alright, so that's everything I've done. Yep, gone from settlement to settlement, made a couple weapon modifications. Let's go do some exploring. So I think I want to focus on some quests now. I was thinking of focusing on the main quest, because, like, I think I vaguely remember something about a baby in danger, someone's baby. I think I'm supposed to save a baby or something. I'm gonna do other stuff. Let's do other quests. Miscellaneous Investigate Vault 81. I do not remember getting this quest. That sounds really fun. Let's do it. Where are you? It's pretty close to Diamond City, which is where I need to go for the main quest, and I also have a quest for Hangman's Alley. So, you know what? Maybe we should just do Hangman's Alley. What's my quest for Hangman's Alley? Clear Hangman's Alley. Minutemen scouts have found a promising site for a new settlement, but it's overrun with hostiles. Preston has asked me to clear it out so a beacon can be set up to attract new settlers in need of a home. Oh. Okay, yeah, let's do Hangman's Alley, and then after we clear that, head on over to Vault 81, which is just west of it. Also, I think I can turn in my ghoul problems quest to Preston.
Need something?
Hold on a second, Preston. Worship the dog. Respect the dog.
Psst. Hold. Let's go. I cleared out the ghouls that were giving that settlement trouble.
Glad to hear it, General. It's hard enough out here without people. Mm-hmm. I'll let you know if I hear anything in the meantime.
Mm-hmm. Fascinating. Fascinating, Preston. Oh, I'm so close to leveling up. Like 10 more XP and I'll be over the line.
Anything Excuse new? Me.
I've heard of another settlement that's in trouble. Here's where they are.
Okay, cool. I thought he said he'd let me know if there's another settlement in trouble, and then he doesn't let me know and I have to ask about it. Come on, Preston. Alright, Hangman's Alley. Oh god, they already spotted me. Shit. Level up! That was quick. I'm not gonna level up just yet, actually. There's some stuff I wanna do to level up. I wanna test.
Let's go!
Oh, okay, so this should give me an increased chance to hit them in bats because dog meat has them pinned to the ground. Yeah, those are really good chances. Nice dog meat, nice. I see your head. Do not expose your head to a sniper. Combat tip number one. But please don't listen to my combat tips, because I'm kind of trying to kill you. Turret. Another one. Where? I heard it. Wasn't that a turret? Oh, there you are. Come on, dog meat, where are they? I know they're still here, right? Right? Or was it the turret that was marked on my compass? Night vision quad barrel missile launcher. Quad barrel? Are you telling me this thing shoots four missiles at one time? Or just that you don't need to reload it? Until you've shot four missiles. Who needs a night vision scope on a missile launcher? That seems a little bit over the top. Okay, I'm gonna test something out with the level ups. Yeah, I'm gonna test something. I'll be right back. Wow, okay, I just confirmed something that is incredibly cool and useful to me, but also makes no sense. And I'm guessing most people don't know this because it doesn't make any sense. So, one of the perks you can get is Lone Wanderer. Who needs friends anyway? When adventuring without a companion, you take 15% less damage and carry weight increases by 50. The obvious idea being that's trying to make up for the fact that you don't have somebody to help you carry stuff, or somebody to help you, survive. So it buffs you when you're not with somebody else. Now, of course, I thought that's pointless because I'm always going to be with dog meat, right? So that's never going to actually take effect. However, it actually does take effect, but only when you're with dog meat. Apparently when it says when you're adventuring without a companion, what it means is when you're adventuring without a human companion. Apparently, since dog meets a dog, he doesn't count, for some reason, as a companion. Yeah, apparently dog meat does not count as a companion because he's not a human. Which makes no sense, because you can only have one companion at one time. And when you try to get somebody else, like Preston Garvey, into your group, for example, you have to tell dog meat to go back. You have to leave dog meat and take Preston instead. So when it comes to the number of companions you can have with you, dog meat counts. But when it comes to this perk, dog meat doesn't count. I'm honestly not convinced that that's actually not a bug, because that really does not make any damn sense. But it works. Taking 50% less damage across the board is really nice, and honestly, the thing I care about the most, though, is my carry weight being increased by 50, because oh my god, does carry weight drive me crazy. So, yes please, I'll take it. It's so horrible. Apparently dog meat's not a real person. Fucking bigots. Assholes. Don't worry, Dogmeat, I know you're a real person. I'm just taking advantage of the system, okay?
Hey, wait there. Come on!
Oh wait, I was about to go inside of this place, but there's no point. I'm trying to go to Hangman's Alley. Wait, but why are there raiders outside of here? Have I not been inside of this place? I'm pretty sure I've been inside of this place. I don't know. I'm just gonna keep going. If I don't focus on the quest right now, I'm never gonna get it done. So in case you're wondering, my max carry weight went from 240 to 290. And typically I was sitting about 50 or 60 pounds under the limit, so now I can hold about 100 extra pounds before I hit the limit. What are you? I can't Vatsum, so I'm not sure what their name is. Where is that to? Oh, that's around Diamond City. Well, that's not where we're going. Enemies. Raider scum. I think they just noticed the body.
Nice.
Don't you die on me.
Oh, I know you're here. I'll find you.
Let's test out this new... the new receiver on this weapon. Oh, maybe not. We're moving further away. They keep getting awfully close to finding me, but they haven't spotted me yet. Oh, it's coming over again.
No need to hide. It'll all be over soon.
Ah, spotted.
Huh?
Get him, dog meat. Yeah. You get his arm, I'll get his head. Pop. I love that you can loot the little gibs of body parts just left on the ground. Just reach right into those bloody pockets. Okay, I'm gonna start taking a bit more stuff. I'll take some of the maybe slightly better weapons, since I've got more carry weight. Okay, is it craft a, craft a what? Recruitment radio beacon. Okay. What the? I think that was a mini nuke. Okay, I believe recruitment beacon is under... I think it's under power miscellaneous. Yeah, here it is. This place is really cramped. Plop it down there. Now we need some power. There we go. Whoa, gunfire happening around. Alright, well there's zero people here. So I guess there's not much point in building anything, and there's already a couple beds. I guess I'll plop down a couple basic resources. Just in case somebody does actually arrive. So there's no water and there's no food. Oh. No concrete. That's right, this place isn't actually hooked up to any supply line, so I don't have access to the supplies in my other places. I'll have to wait for somebody to show up then, and then I'll assign them to a supply line. Or something like that. Okay, well, let's move on to Vault 81. I've got to pick the lock to my own damn settlement, what? Lame. Shouldn't I have the keys?
Sweet.
See what all that action's about. What are you? Mutant Hound? Caravan Guard. Oh, I need to protect you. There you go. Super mutants. I'll help you. Stand back.
What just happened?
Why is she just sitting down? Cricket. I don't know who Cricket is, but why is she just sitting down on the stairs in a really weird position? Next to a super mutant.
We ain't easy pickings, asshole.
Wait, who's shooting at the caravan car? Super mutant skirmisher. Oh! You got laser weapons. Get him, dog meat! Get him!
I survived everything the Welts ever thrown at me.
I think that's everyone. Nice, I see these caravan guards are highly competent, sitting on stairs next to their enemies, running into poles. That's enough looting. I want to check out this vault, I want to make sure I have enough time for it. Whoa! Make way! Guess when the mutants attacked, the Brahmin just ran and hid. Smart. Push the pram. Thing must be made out of foam. Doesn't make a sound.
I hear something!
Get him, dog meat.
Do it! Scream!
Oh, shit.
Scream for mercy!
Okay, better heal before I burn to death. Reservoir. Hmm. Well, I am just right here. I might as well explore it, huh? Let's go check it out. Blood flies. Spooky house over there. Yeah, someone's got some, like, whoops, some makeshift power set up over there or something. Completed. Investigate Vault 81. What? I haven't even gotten to Vault 81. What are you talking about, Quest? Huh. Looks like I've already cleared this place. I guess just the bugs was it. Well, let's see if we can go inside of any of these places. Yeah, I guess the investigate, just like the insane asylum, just means go there. Doesn't mean you have to actually do anything there, just go to it, and you're good. No dog! Oh, God. This bloodfly had a kickball on it, what? What the hell is that monstrosity? Looks like it's designed to produce sparks. Anyone home? Oh, shit! Okay, bad idea. That seems awfully dangerous to put the switch for that, like, right next to the thing that shocks you to death. Edwin's terminal. What did you do here, Edwin? Data loss detected. Please contact a technician for assistance. Well, at least there's a tape. Wait, what? Welcome, Edwin. Please select an entry. Bess and I got in just before sundown. Old place is still in one piece. The north side sunk a little more. Need to shore it up the next time I'm out this way. Spring? Whole place has been trashed, though. Damn raiders. Take me a week or two to get it cleaned out again. Forgot how nice it was to get off the road. Bess seems to be settling in well, too. Hard to believe it's been 10 years. I still remember Annika leveling that shotgun at me. What an introduction. I think we were both glad she never pulled the trigger. Couple of bloatflies bothering Bess this morning. Chased them off. Nasty things. Spent the afternoon rigging up a zapper with parts from the old generator. Seems to work well enough. One jolt of that ought to keep them away for good. Huh. Oversized bug zapper for oversized bugs. Shooting stars tonight. Sat on the deck and watched them, just like we used to. She's been gone 3 winters now. All I've got left is her locket, and this old place. She deserved better. Aww. Out fishing when the bugs came back. Bloatflies and worse. Hell of a swarm. I got a couple of good shots off, but upset the boat. Had to swim back. I think I drove them off, at least for now. Bess is spooked, but she'll be alright. If this keeps up, we'll leave first thing in the morning. I can't find the locket. It must have slipped out of my pocket when the boat flipped over. I have to go back. It's all I got to remember her by. I can't lose it, too. Huh. So I guess I could probably find it out there where the boat is. Let's do that. Hold on, let me just see if I can take the tape with me. Yeah, take it with me. Crap. Mine, Mentats, Molotov Cocktail, Radex, Stealth Boy. That thing's worth a lot. Stimpak. Good safe. I think I'm gonna dump my stuff. Hey. I'm probably reaching the limit pretty soon. Yeah, I'm getting there. Especially the missile launcher. This thing weighs... Oh, this thing weighs 48. Jesus. I've got so much more weight now. I love it. Okay, so aside from the thing that should be in the water, the locket, is there any other buildings around here? Oh, blowfly. Alright. Let's go diving. Put on our hazmat suit. That light is terrible. Okay, so it should be probably directly beneath the boat, I'm guessing. Oh, cap stash. I wish the cap stashes were bigger in this game. I mean, 18 caps for that stash, that's just not much. Alright. Edwin's key. Oh, there's a body. Whoa, what's that noise? Oh shit, there's blowflies up there. Oh, what? They can shoot me through the water? They're getting dog meat, no! Assholes. Jesus. Whoa, what? Was that a crit or something, or did it hit me in the head? Because those attacks didn't seem to be doing that much damage before. I'm trying to whip out my shotgun, I wanted to test it out. Oh, this is from before everything. I'll be right back. Okay, let's try that again. This time without the dying bard. Oh, right, hazmat suit. Also, I'd really like to know where those bugs came from. Because I don't see them. No, oh, there's the one over there still. Maybe it's an event. Like, maybe it's scripted. When you go down there, they spawn. Yeah, because where else could they have come from? It must be a script. Yep, they spawned.
I
How about you die? Thanks. Do I want to waste a shot on my good sniper rifle on you? Nah. Wasted a lot of ammo, but I don't care. Got 1,000 shots with this thing. Alright, so there's the key. Medical place. Now, what about the locket? It's just almost impossible to see anything. Alright, you know what, I'm actually gonna put my good stuff on, just so I can actually see. That allows me to see marginally better. Oh crap. Explosives are cool. But I want the locket. I really want the locket. I'm gonna keep searching and I'll be right back. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, there it is. It's right below the hand of the corpse. Yeah, it's... Oh man, it blends in so well. I didn't even see it. I saw the text. Annika's locket. Got it. Alright, let's get rid of that radiation. Some rat away. Let's eat something. Okay, so it's... what's it under? Probably miscellaneous. No. What?! Oh my god, are you serious? It's considered junk? That's, like, darkly humorous, but also it's genuinely just... like, I'm genuinely disappointed. I mean, I read these entries about this person and their life, and they mention the locket, and then they mention where it is, and I get excited that I can actually find it, and, you know, cool enough, it is actually there, but then you find it, and all the sentimentality of the item is lost when it's just filed under junk and it's worth 2 silver and that's it. Like, there's really nothing more to it. But that's it. That's it. That's so disappointing. Alright, well, let's finally go explore the vault. Something doesn't feel right. Yeah, hold on. Okay, that's weird. Okay, now I think it's fine. Yep, there we go, fixed. Sensitivity issue. I just fixed it because I accidentally hit one of the sensitivity button changers on my mouse. My bad. This place has working lights. Does that mean it's inhabited? Probably. Restricted area. like that's going to stop me.
Security. I don't know where you got your hands on a working pit boy, but you better start talking.
I got it in Vault 111.
Vault 111? Haven't heard of that one yet. And what sort of business are you looking to take care of here in 81?
Just exploration, I suppose.
I'm just a traveler. I thought I'd take a look around.
Is that so? And you expect me to believe that? Oh, Overseer.
Who is it, Edwards?
Ma'am, some new Commonwealth traveler. Not one of our usual traders.
Well, if someone wants in, they can earn it like everyone else. Let me speak to them.
Awkward
Sorry
silences.
About that. Officer Edwards here was just doing his job. I'm sure you can understand our need for caution. For newcomers, we like to operate on exchange. You help us, we help you.
So, looks like there's a pretty low chance of me actually being able to convince them. But, I might as well try, right?
But I'm a fellow vault dweller. Can't you just let me in?
Excuse me, ma'am. Before you arrived, she did say she was from Vault 111.
Oh my god, I actually passed that skill check.
She's in possession of a working pit boy.
Is that so?
Huh. What is with these awkward pauses?
I'm going to allow it. Edwards, open the door and make the announcement. Officer Edwards and I will meet you at the entrance.
This is really cool, though. Fellow vault dwellers. I wonder what their story is going to be. Were they tricked as well?
Come on, Gwen. My guys have been working doubles for weeks now. They need a break.
Everyone's working hard right now, Cal. You think I don't know that? Just do the best with what you can. That's all I'm asking.
Fine. I'll see what I can do. But you and I both know we can't keep going on like this.
Music.
Sorry about that. Excuse me, where do you think you're going?
Sorry, just turning off the radio. You know, copyright, potential issues.
Overseer, ready to talk now? We've never encountered a fellow vault dweller. Is this Vault 111 you mentioned still operational?
It's more like a graveyard now. Almost no survivors.
Christ, I'm sorry. What happened there?
I love that my mining helmet has a flashlight on top of it and it's just shining its super bright beam directly into her eyes. It's gotta be really unpleasant.
They had us cryogenically frozen in these pods. But something malfunctioned.
Oh my god. All those lives lost due to some malfunction? That's unacceptable.
I suppose we've been lucky.
Here, we pride ourselves on having maintained a successful vault over these past two centuries. We'd like to be completely self-sufficient, but there are certain resources we can't provide ourselves.
I'm impressed you maintained a successful vault for this long.
Thanks. I owe it to the overseers before me, but some here would disagree. A few believe opening the doors to the Commonwealth was a mistake.
Interaction is a good thing. The Commonwealth is improving.
So I've heard. But it's still got a long ways to go. Now, I have work to do.
Ma'am, what about the dog?
I'll allow it. Security is already extra mindful, isn't
it? Yeah, you better allow
it. She's lived this long in the Commonwealth. I'm sure she's chosen her friends wisely. If you need anything else, I'll be in my office.
Hope you're not making any trouble.
Huh. So that's the end of the quest, I guess. Yeah, there's gotta be more to do here, though. People to talk to, people that maybe have quests of their own. I mean, she says they can't get everything they need, right? So maybe I can hook her up with whatever she needs? Maybe they need food or something? Let's talk to some people.
Another outsider? What'd they let you in for?
What's with the attitude?
I don't trust outsiders. We didn't need your help before, we don't need it now. The Overseer never should have opened up the vault to your kind.
Okay. Little xenophobic there.
Well, aren't you a ray of sunshine?
You think you're funny? That's exactly why outsiders don't belong here.
Because we have senses of humor? Fuck you.
Excuse me.
If you're looking for friendly conversation, you won't find it here.
Hey, Dogmeat. Can you bite her ankle?
Hey.
Ah, apparently not.
Don't try anything.
Excuse me.
Hey, an outsider with a vault suit. There's something you don't see every day. Don't say anything, but man, I'd love to be out there.
Wait, is he not allowed to leave?
It takes some preparation. I'd learn how to use a gun and be ready to use it before I went out there.
I've never even touched a gun. Now, I can't even say if our security has seen any real combat, but with the hours we're working these days, I'm not even sure where I'd find the time to practice.
Why the long hours?
We're just making sure this roof over our heads doesn't cave in on us. They say it's all the moving parts that have us working round the clock these days. Structurally, I guess 81 is still pretty sound. Vault Tech sure knew what they were doing when they set these places up. Well, I don't want to keep you, and I gotta get back to work. Maybe I'll see you around.
Pardon me, officer.
Calvin's always looking for tools. I heard he'll pay caps if you got him.
Who's Calvin? Let's see if we can go find him. Man, no point in trying to loot stuff, because it's all considered stealing.
No signs of radiation. Impressive.
Hey.
Huh? If you want a good meal, see Maria at the cafeteria. She'll hook you up.
Hey, Ashes.
It's been a while since someone from the Commonwealth last visited us.
Oh!
Ash!
Damn it.
Kitty cat!
I'm not going to like this.
Dog meat! Look at the kitty cat!
Over there.
Where are you going? Where are you going? Where are you going, kitty cat? Come back! You're not going to leave the vault or something, are you? That cat has really weird animations. Oh god. Oh god, it just left. What? No. You can't survive out there, can you? I've never seen a cat out. Oh! Where are you going? Cat! Cat! You don't belong out here. Oh my god. Alright, we have an escort quest here. A very, very important escort quest here. And also, my gun and hands are invisible. What? Game? Can I... Okay, my guns and hands are just completely invisible. Cool. Well, let's not think about that now. Dogmeat, we have a very important escort quest here. We must protect this cat. We must see where it's going. Ashes, send home. Yes, go home, kitty. Go home.
Ashes, go home. Aaron misses you.
That cat is terribly animated. It's like a horribly, demonically possessed robotronic monster cat, but still it's a cute cat. Even if it does look kind of creepy the way it moves. So it's actually a quest. I actually started a quest by chasing it. Oh, good job, Dogmeat. You helped scare it in the direction of the vault. Gonna make sure you get home safely. I wanna watch you go back inside. Oh, disappear for a second. No, you got, oh, you're phasing. You're kind of phasing through the dimensions. Cat dimension, human dimension, cat dimension, human dimension. Did you find out how to go to the right dimension? Yeah, I think so. Let's see what the oh my god. The Pip-Boy's invisible too. I can't even see my quests because I can't see the screen. Okay, let's make a save and load it and hope that fixes it. Yes, it fixed it. Okay. Here, kitty kitty. Talk to Aaron.
Everything's under control.
Work never ends in Vault 81.
We got a barber here if you need it. Not saying you do.
Barber? Oh, I can change my hair if I wanted to. Cool.
Sorry about the maintenance. It never ends these days.
And Dogmeat just disappeared. Okay. Oh, and Dogmeat's back.
Hey, wait there. Come on. Hold position. Moving out.
Aaron. Wow, this place is huge.
Again? But I
need
your
help. You got guts wearing that pit boy in the Commonwealth. I can't believe someone hasn't tried to steal it yet.
Please, you haven't. Tired of these tools giving out on me. Don't they know there's work to be done?
Oh, so Aaron and I can just
wait? Dr. Penske runs a hydroponics lab.
Gone more than you're here. We have some work for you. Whatever happened to loving husband and father?
Sorry, I can't stop to listen to any of their conversations. I have things to do. I must tell them their cat is safe. There you are. Oh, sorry to interrupt, class. There's the kitty cat!
Ashes! You found him!
I did!
Thanks, ma'am! I was so worried about him.
Oh, don't worry. Your demonic cat has returned to you. It'll steal your soul in your sleep.
You're welcome.
I'm so glad he's safe. Ashes!
Oh, she gave me a fusion core.
I was so worried about you. And I bet Mom's gonna make me give you a bath.
You look tired.
Silent meow from Ashes.
I know, I don't like it either. But I'm just happy you're back.
It keeps happening. I let old Rusty. Maybe he can check it out.
Can't afford to lose any more sleep with these.
I just love this scene right here. Dogmeat staring at me and the cat. Look at the way the cat turns. It's so, what? It's so creepy. Oh my god, you're a creepy cat. But I love you anyway. Alright, well, this place is obviously huge. There's a lot of people to talk to.
Did Pip-Boy ever act up on you?
And I can't wait to. Oh!
Lady?
What?
Hey, lady! Where are you going?
Where are you going? He says as he then runs away from me.
Hey, over here!
Come on, Dogmeat. So this place is huge, there's a lot of people to talk to. Dogmeat just disappeared again, but I'm sure he'll be back in just a second. There he is. And I feel pretty satisfied after having completed the kitty cat quest. Don't you, Dogmeat,
hey,
don't you?
Stay there. On me. Stay there, boy.
Yeah.
Hey, let's go.
So I think I'm gonna end the episode here. I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I am going to properly explore this place, talk to everybody, and see what we can do to help these people.